Hello, and welcome to 502 Sessions. I'm your host, Brian Kirby. My guest today is Sinner's Pie. This acoustic music trio plays music in the traditional, folk, and bluegrass style, and the band was co-founded by Nelson Hiller and Carol Campbell. They both play guitar, mandolin, and sing. The trio is rounded out with Dave Carney on bass. Nelson writes the lyrics and basic melodies to the songs, and then the band collaborates on the overall musical arrangements. They've performed on the main stage at Bluegrass on the Bogs in Hansen, Massachusetts, for the Pawtucket Arts Council, for Philanthropy Tea and Coffee Music Series, and at Nick and Nees Bluegrass Throedown in Providence. I'm very pleased to present Sinner's Pie.
Well, she hung around in heaven just waiting there for me. She could have traveled the world, she could have sailed the seven seas, she could have been the seven wonders, but she wanted to be with me. Yeah, she could have been an artist, she could have wrote a perfect melody. Could have had any soul she wanted me. She could have been a big star, a song or old movie. One look in her eyes, you'll know just what I mean. She could have been Lady Godiva, riding horseback to the Queen, but she hung around in heaven just waiting there for me. Well, she could have married a banker in the gold rush century. She could have had all that money, but she wanted to be with me. Yeah, she could have been an outlaw with Clyde just like Bonnie. She could have been that famous, but she wanted to be with me. She could have been a big star, song or old movies. One look in her eyes, you'll know just what I mean. She could have been Lady Godiva, riding horseback to the Queen, but she hung around in heaven just waiting there for me. She could have been Lady Godiva, riding horseback to the Queen, but she hung around in heaven just waiting there for me. She's my angel. Well, I came to town to kill a man for a debt that he once owed. I've been riding many miles up and down these dusty roads. Found him in a church house one early Sunday morning. He's standing out in front of them all saying something about the Lord. Oh no, I guess I'm here to kill the preacher man. I made a promise to the boss, I'm sticking to that plan. Said the boss man's got my girl holed up in old Cheyenne. Never see my love again without the death of the preacher man. Mm-hmm. Sunday morning, listening to those preacher's words tell me right from wrong. Little did that preacher know those words he passed around, telling me it might be okay to finally put him down. He said when a man does wrong, he always owns that debt, but if he gives his life to the Lord, there won't be no regrets. Well, I just took his words and I spun him around a bit, and I gave the Lord the preacher's life, saved the girl I sorely missed. Story's got one ending. They dig a hole, put me in it. That's when the Lord comes down and says,
you know you killed a man.
That's right.
But you saved the girl.
Uh-huh.
Now you break even, come on in. I said, that's right, I killed a man, but I did it to save the girl. That's when the Lord smiled down at me, and I walk through those gates of pearl. Same old history, run this way a billion years, swept away you and me, carried us down from the mountain, heading down to the deep blue sea, floating hand in hand, getting closer to the sea. Ah, but then the day came, it's happened to us all. Got caught in the rapids and went over the waterfall. Yeah, we trusted the speed of the river, it was just too far to fall. Trusted the speed of love and went over the waterfall. Down through the canyon, wherever true love did go, down to the valley and the meadows where those wildflowers grow. Seemed like the worst was over, heard a distant melody, floating hand in hand, getting closer to the sea. Ah, but then the day came, it's happened to us all. We got caught in the rapids and went over the waterfall. Yeah, we trusted the speed of the river, it was just too far to fall. Trusted the speed of love, it went over the waterfall. Oh no! We went over the waterfall. Look out! waterfall. Throw me a rope. Went over the waterfall.
Go 502 Sessions with Sinner's Pie, and Nelson Hiller, co-founder, has been nominated to be the spokesman for the band today. So co-founded by Nelson Hiller, Carol Campbell on guitar, and Dave Carney here on bass. So you write the lyrics to these songs, and then you all collaborate on the rest of it? So they don't throw anything in with the lyrics?
No, I'll come in with the words and a basic sort of chord progression, and I'll show them what I have, and we'll go look at it, and these guys will all together will decide how maybe we need a bridge here, or maybe here's, and Carol sort of drives the harmonies in the right direction, and Dave has different ideas on how the song should be structured. So it's really a pleasure to come in with a song and kind of watch it change into what it ends up becoming.
When you're writing, the lyrics come first or the melody comes first, both together?
Yeah, well, I'll get an idea. I'll see an idea out in the world someplace, and I will write the lyrics out. And then kind of write them down in a notebook. And then I'll come back to it another time when maybe a melody comes to me and I'll put them together. Sometimes they come together, but very rarely for me does a melody come first. I'm more of a sort of word writer.
So mostly a story?
Mostly a story or a series of words around an event or a feeling.
And you bring it into the band as a story and you talk about the lyric, or you bring in the finished lyric and...
I bring in...
Carol's nodding here, so...
Yeah.
So just say yes.
Yes, okay. Yes, that's what I do. I bring it in...
A full lyric.
Full lyric and a bass chord progression.
So you will play the chords,
yes,
and you'll sing it to them.
Yes, that's what I'll do.
And the lyric is set. Nobody says change that and to a then or a to. That part's set. There's a story you're telling. Well, actually, take me through one of those tunes. So, Over the Waterfall. Run those lyrics down for me, because I was listening, and let me hear the story of that.
So that one kind of came. So here's Over the Waterfall is an old-time fiddle song that we would play in bluegrass circles. And I would actually use that song a lot at times when I was writing. So when I write words, I need a cadence. So I would write to some other progression just to get the words out. So I got the 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. And I used Over the Waterfall an awful lot because it would...
The chord progression
Over the Waterfall for some reason allowed me to apply it to a different chorus or a different version of melody later, and it always transposed well. So I used it a lot. And then I decided one day that I really needed to, I think I owed it its own song.
Over the Waterfall, you've used the chord progression many times to write many different melodies and many different lyrics. It just gets you started.
It's the cadence. It's a cadence. And
play the cadence for me.
So the song, the bluegrass song is... So I would be, love's like a river, share the same old history. And so it would allow me to put those words into a notebook. And then later, when I get an idea for a sort of a melody or a song progression, I go back to the notebook. And a lot of times I don't know what song I wrote it to, but I've got the words there. So then I'll take those words and I'll see if the meaning has the same feeling as the melody, and I'll kind of put them together. So at any given time, I could have 3 or 4 different songs sort of in the works, sitting in line waiting for the music to come along.
And the lyric has its own rhythm, so when you go back and read a lyric you haven't seen for a while, a natural rhythm comes out?
Yeah. You really should be able to stand there and read your song in a way that you would understand, or in a cadence that you would recognize. So you don't cheat and hold one word for a long period of time because you need to be in time for the next change. You want to be able to sort of articulate that word a little bit more because you've got some time. So if I sat here and said, love is like a river, same old hit, you'd look at me and say, what's he talking? But in a song, that could kind of go, but it's a little bit of a cheat to do that.
Oh, so you, okay.
So why waste that time to hold when you can add a couple more words to kind of articulate a little bit more than the message?
That makes sense. So do you do a lot of workshops to help you? I say the word workshop. You said lyric writing camps, you call
them?
Yeah,
camps.
So is that a bunch of bluegrass people, or is it all songwriters of all genres?
It's all songwriters. Well, this is the ones that I go to are driven towards bluegrass. And so I'll go to, there's a local festivals that might have a Friday afternoon songwriters gathering, or I actually went to.
And at the gathering, do you pitch each other songs and there's feedback from them?
No, or you usually have a person there who's a sort of established songwriter.
So they lead the workshop.
They kind of lead the workshop, and they'll listen to you and they'll critique.
So do you sing the words, or you just recite them to hear
the
kids?
No, well, you'll sing it as a whole piece, and that's where some of that comes out of, is the critique of, you know, you're wasting a lot of time that you could sort of be a little more succinct about the subject matter.
Let's get specific here. Talk to me about the last tune, With You. So, a ballad, love story.
Yeah, so that's a comparison of sort of.
Do you remember how that came to you?
Yeah, that one came to me. It was just a song that I wrote about why she's so important to me.
Okay. One specific person you're thinking at the time?
Yes.
Okay.
One specific person. And so, it's the line that came to me is that if I'm a mountain, then you're the gold, meaning I'm nothing without you. And so that's really what the whole song is about, is that without you, I'm not all these things, and I'm all these things because of you. So I compare if I'm this, it's because you're that.
And you bring the song in such as that one, you play the melody, you strum the chords, Carol hears it, you come up with a harmony on your own, or he says, I'm hearing this, or you just come out with it and Nelson goes, hey, that sounds great. It's all her, you're saying. The harmony is all her.
I came in going, love is like a river.
And she said, don't do that.
And she said, don't do that. And she's kind of pulled me down, and then.
So she's the artistic director as well.
Well, yeah, she somehow knows how I should be singing so that we match.
Well, yeah, I think a lot of his volume came from singing solo, doing solo, you know, like open mics and stuff like that, and it just needed to be toned down. I didn't teach him how to sing per se, but just dynamics. And I think, as far as where the song goes or where the harmonies are, or we pretty much agree on all of that too, as far as the dynamics of the song. And so it's not just any one of us, you know, it's a
definitely trio
collaboration.
Yeah.
Yes.
Dave, you're kind of quiet. You agree?
I agree completely.
All right, great. Let's hear some more music then.
Right.
All right. Sinner's Pie on 502 Sessions.
Ah, here's the day I meet my maker, even though I was falsely tried. The same old story, I fit the description. Found myself at the scene of the crime. Executioner, please make it painless. And for you, my ring of gold. He says, son, thanks for the offer, but your gold ring already came, he came to cleanse me, wash away that world of sin. And I said, Father, you two are mistaken, there's only goodness here within. Executioner, please make it painless, and for you, my ring of gold. He said, son, but you go.
governor called. He said he's sorry. 12 good men said you must die. I don't agree. Who am I now? Some elected man in his foolish pride. Tired of the sun, takes all the blame when I'm having too much fun. Shakes the back road when that highway's too smooth. Makes me feel young, I'm getting long in the tooth. She can make me laugh when I really should be crying. Always tells the truth when everybody else is lying. Takes my breath when I really should be breathing. Opens up her world, my world. All this adds up to, gonna be just fine. She's my shiny little diamond in this old cold mine. Even when she's late, you know she's right on time. She's my shiny little diamond in this old cold mine. She'll speak softly when I'm thinking out loud. Makes me feel lonely when I'm standing in a crowd. Sails me straight when it wants to come around. Shine like an angel when that devil's in town. Now all this adds up to, we're gonna be just fine. She's my shiny little diamond in this old cold mine. When she's late, no, she's right on time. She's my shiny little diamond in this old coal mine. Now all this adds up to, gonna be just fine. Shiny little diamond in this old coal mine. And even when she's late, you know she's right on time. She's my shiny little diamond in this old coal mine. She's my shiny little diamond in this old. Heartache out
wrong. Don't leave no promises just to be broken. Don't leave no number for me to call. Please don't leave. Don't leave me nothing when you go. Please don't leave. Don't leave me nothing when you go. Please don't leave.
502 Sessions, back again with Sinner's Pie, Nelson Hiller, Carol Campbell, and Dave Carney on bass. All right, we've covered the music writing, although I could talk a lot more about that, but now let me ask some more general questions. So what's the Sinner's Pie, apostrophe Sinner's Pie? Okay, what's the name about? Carol, I guess step up to the mic.
Question of the day. We kind of, I don't know, it's there's no real story behind it, except I was leafing through some gospel material that I had, and there was a gospel, a book of gospel songs, and I saw the name of the song, this song, Methodist Pie, and was the name of the song. So when I was thinking of, oh, what are we going to name ourselves, Nelson? You know, we were going back and forth because we needed a name for the Bogs, right? And so
it couldn't be Nelson Hiller and the other two.
It could be, well, and that's what he suggested.
I wanted it to be just Nelson Hiller, but I got voted down.
So anyway, I wanted it. I don't know. I thought of something a little edgy, because some of his writings are a little edgy too, in your subject matters and stuff. So sinners. I don't know. I mean, that's the best explanation I can come up with.
That's good. That's good.
When people ask us out, you know, when we're playing, I just tell them what, you know, I ask them what they think. You know, what does it mean? Or they're the sinners. I'm the
That's what
the
it
pie.
Sounds like. You're the pie for sinners. Or there's
that's what I've got. You know, those are some of the responses I've gotten. But yeah, that's it.
Well, that leads into, where did you three meet? Were you solo acts before? What happened? You meet at an open mic night, or
we've seen each other in the bluegrass circles for a lot of years, and we'd play together at jams, and we'd see each other at festivals, and then.
So were you saw
Carol
each other?
Carol was in one band, and
okay,
I was in another band.
You saw each other on other.
Dave's
been in different bands. So we've all played in different bands at different festivals, and would hang out and pick and jam afterwards, and then. One day it was, let's try something.
We were all band free, so
yeah.
We decided to
band together.
So when this isn't your band, and then maybe Dave, you're a sideman in another band, this is your band. And this is same for Carol and Nelson?
Right.
Yeah.
Pretty much, yes.
Sometimes we've, you know, bass players, you know, get to play with different people. So, you know. And I'll play with, fill in sometimes for friends, and just like we might have a guest come play with us. You share back and forth, those kinds of things. But yeah, we're pretty much.
We are committed as.
This is it. We're a three piece, and then we might, you know, invite a fiddle player come play sometime, or a banjo player to play with us. But the core of it's this and our songs.
How did you, I guess I'll ask this question individually as of a source, how did you learn to play? Is there any formal training here? Did you pick up guitars and as children?
Not me.
Okay, we'll start with Carol.
No formal training. I didn't start playing or really being involved in music until I was 40. So
nothing.
Nothing.
You would sing it with the radio in the car.
I grew up.
So you
listening.
Just started 1 year ago.
Yeah, well, yeah. Has it already been a year? Yeah. That was, I don't know. My training was listening to music growing up.
So how were you drawn to bluegrass? And so you didn't play, you didn't sing, and then you picked up a guitar and wanted to sing, and bluegrass was your road?
I mean, well,
that was,
actually,
bluegrass was your lady? So
the first instrument I had was given to me by my family for my 40th birthday. So that's why I started playing something. And it was a mandolin. So where I was living at the time, I sought out this circle of people who I eventually met, these two, at this Bluegrass monthly jam, and it was right in my town. So I took my mandolin.
Hold on a second. So let me back up. So your family gives you a mandolin, you get this present, and then you say, I guess I'll go to the Bluegrass jam and see what's going on.
Well, it took me a while to make that decision.
Well, you could go look. Why? Okay.
But yeah, so I brought it with me, and I started, you know, just listening and watching people play the mandolin and listening to the music. I mean, I was already familiar with bluegrass music, so yeah, that's basically it. I went and then a friend of mine, who is now a friend of mine, but then I didn't really, you know too many people in that circle, asked me to come and sit in on his jams, Friday night jams or whatever, and I met other people there, and that's how I met my duo partner, Diana Fallon, and we formed Blue Around the Edges from that. But so she was playing guitar, I was playing mandolin as best we could, and really, I was playing the instrument to accompany myself more than trying to learn the mandolin, because really what I wanted to do was sing.
Okay, so the mandolin was a vehicle.
Right.
Okay. Dave, step up to the mic, if you don't mind. Carol, step aside. Sorry. So Dave, bass, boom, boom, root, fifth.
Root, fifth. I started off playing guitar, and when I was about 12, I was taking lessons with a guy named Frank Silva, who's still big in Northeast New England bluegrass and used to orchestrate jams and things like that. And he said, you know, if you want to get good, you got to play with other people. So I started going out to bluegrass jams and barns and just playing guitar back then. And then being young and not finding anybody my age, I went off to punk music for about 10, 15 years and played in some...
Bluegrass to punk and back again.
Bluegrass to punk and
back
again.
That's the circle of life.
You usually don't come back from that.
There's a Disney movie out of that, right?
There was always a need for a bass player back then, so I moved over to electric bass. And then about 15, 16 years ago, I got my first upright and said, if I could just find some sort of jam, some place where people are sitting picking, I can, you know, have fun playing this. And then that evolved into getting back into playing gigs out. And so about 15, 18 years, I've been doing a lot of bluegrass. I still do some original punk and harder edge stuff with my brother actually looking at 50s tribute with some other people that should be interesting.
Oh, all right, Carol, come back up, form the trio, and I'll talk to Nelson. So, wow. All right, Nelson, down to you. So what's your life story with music?
Well, I started in elementary school playing the trumpet with the elementary band.
Okay, so now there's a history.
Yes, and then I played trumpet through high school.
Wow.
And then I went off to college, and they didn't seem to be too interested in trumpets up there, but guitars they liked.
Where was that?
New England College in Henniker, New Hampshire. I'd played some guitar in my senior
year. So you weren't going
school.
For music. You went to college.
Just to go to college.
All right.
See what they knew. And so I started playing guitar. Probably the senior year of high school is when I really started playing guitar. Not bluegrass. I didn't run into bluegrass. Then I played saxophone for 5 or 6 years. I liked the learning curve. I think I like that, and then you get up to that old long road that you're on with everybody else takes you a long time. And so, but it wasn't as communal. So when I found bluegrass, I bought a mandolin, said I want to play bluegrass, because I went to a bluegrass festival and I saw all these people sitting in circles playing, and I said, this has got me written all over it.
All right, well, how about some more music? Moving on. Sinner's Pie, 502 Sessions.
Was going out to all the Civil War veterans.
Young hometown boys, fresh from their mothers, cannonball rise, cannonball rise. Blue gray fields, brothers fighting. They've done to their only cannonball.
Let my baby go on northbound train. She never came back. Now there's only me to blame. Why didn't anybody tell me? I had another drink. I said, what the heck? And drove a little fast and I ended up in a wreck. Why didn't anybody tell me? Oh, why didn't anybody? Oh, why didn't anybody? Oh, why didn't anybody tell me? Just a good old boy going down the road, smile when I can, do what I'm told. Why didn't anybody tell me? Well, I smoked one cigarette just to be cool. Four packs later, I was smoking like a fool. Why didn't anybody tell me? Yeah, I took a little snort, have a little fun. Woke up in the morning down the barrel of a gun. Why didn't anybody tell me? Oh, why didn't anybody? Oh, why didn't anybody? Why didn't anybody tell me? Just a good old boy going down the road, smile when I can, do what I'm told. Why didn't anybody tell me? Well, I walked down the aisle and I said that I do too. Later, I guess I don't, and we're through. Why didn't anybody tell me? That sweet little girl looked me right in the eye, drove me on home, then she charged me for the ride. Why didn't anybody tell me? Oh, why didn't anybody tell me? Just a good old boy going down the road, smile when I can, do what I'm told. Why didn't anybody tell me? Well, I dropped out of school to make a little cash, spend my whole life dragging around the past. Why didn't anybody tell me? Well, you're born one morning and the next you go to school, work your whole life, then you're dead and it's through. Oh, why didn't anybody tell me? Oh, why didn't anybody? Why didn't anybody tell me? Just a good old boy going down the road, smile when I can, do what I'm told. Why didn't anybody tell me? Time I get thrown from the train. Well, they're loading up the mail, all the passengers in line. Well, I'm pulling in the station about 9:30. Well, the engine's building steam, pressure's rising all the time. Pulling out of Georgia, that pretty girl of mine. Loosen your caboose, we gotta get on. Line. Gotta beat that record, being right on time. If we both pull together, you'll never fail. 100 miles of travel, 200 miles of rest. Shovel up the coal, get that boiler burning hot. I guess it's up to me if we make it or not. Well, the fire went out, and she says that I'm one more time I get thrown from the train. She got her head full of steam, round the mountain here she comes. Get brake man ready for that. Holding up the speed, never go too fast. 100 miles of travel, 200 miles of track. Shovel up the coal, get that boiler burning hot. Guess it's up to me if we make it or not. Well, the fire went out, and she says that I'm to blame. One more time, I get thrown from the train. Well, the fire went out, and she says that I'm to blame. One more time, I get thrown.
.502 Sessions, my guest today has been Sinner's Pie. Nelson Hiller, thank you for being here. Carol Campbell and Dave Carney on bass.
Thank you.
502 Sessions, you can check out more shows at 502sessions.com. And you can contact me directly at 502sessions@gmail.com. The show is all about featuring bands performing their original music. So if you're a musician or you're in a group of musicians, also known as a band, and you have a lot of original music and you think you might make a nice feature show, don't hesitate to get in contact with me because I check out all links and I respond to all emails. 502sessions@gmail.com. Thank you again.
Thank you.
Thank you.
start it all again. If you were a queen, I'd be your king. Stand up high. Together we'd rule the world. And if you were the sunshine, I would surely be the glow. And if I was the tallest mountain, baby, you'd be the gold.